Two people, one womb. 9 months spent stuffed together like sardines in a can. Their personal space gradually disappearing with each passing day, until they are crammed next to each other so tightly that they have to come out or one will devour the other. How can two people spend the first 9 months of their existence together, wrapped in the same cocoon of tissue, nourished by the same flow of fluid, and yet come out so fundamentally different? What is it that decides we are to become? They are born together, they grow up together, they share clothing, secrets, and woe. They live on top of each other just as they grew in utero until one day they don't. They move on to their own personal lives, and there their differences come to light. One chooses intellect, the cool, steady numbers and facts, logic, the fascinating round of exploration and waiting and discovery, predictable, understandable, controllable, the joy of knowing and understanding everything around her. The other chooses emotion, the thrill of living life from one moment to the next, not knowing where you'll be tomorrow or if it even be. The high of living life to the extremes that life can be lived to, because life is too short to take a cautious round.
Hey.
Hey.
How are you holding up?
I'm okay, I think. The doctor called.
What did he say?
She asked if I wanted to have Anne moved to a permanent facility.
A permanent facility?
Yeah. Long-term care.
So they don't think she's coming out of it then?
No. God damn it! Why couldn't she have been more goddamn careful? If she'd just taken the safe, boring route for once in her fucking life, then she wouldn't be in a coma. She'd be alive and awake and...
And what, more like
no,
you?
No, not! She just... Oh, God. You're right. If she'd done anything else, she wouldn't have been Anne. She'd have been, I don't know, Anne Light or something? She would have been me.
Hey, you're not Anne Light. You're Leia. You will pull through this.
If she doesn't wake up, then who am I? She has to wake up.
What do you think she would have wanted?
She's unconscious. She lost her right to an opinion when she stepped into that car.
Leia.
I don't know. She loves life. I don't even know what that would mean now. Is a coma even life, according to her?
Hope. A feeling of expectation and desire for a certain thing to happen. To hope against hope for Anne to wake up. To hope for the best. In hopes of Anne recovering. In hopes that Anne will eventually wake up. Hope springs eternal in the human breast. Not a hope. To make a decision, we must look to why a certain conclusion should be come to. And so she does. She looks to the past.
You know that feeling where you're light as a feather, spinning as fast as a top and as warm as if you'd just gotten out of bed in the morning?
Not really.
Well, that's how I feel right now, as if nothing could possibly go wrong, as if the whole world could fade away into nothing and I'd still be perfectly happy, as if I'm done struggling and I can just coast from here on out because my life goal is uncompleted.
Dave asked you out, didn't he?
Yep.
And how are you going to feel when he dumps you in a couple of months?
He's not going to dump me in a couple of months. I give him at least 6.
He was pretty serious when he asked me.
Yeah, but what's the point? It didn't get you anywhere. 6 months from now, you'll be in exactly the same place as you were yesterday. Single and with all your attention and emotion, caught up in something that doesn't even matter.
The point is, I'm living. I have passion and fun, and I'm not a shriveled up prune with my nose stuck in books. I'll live my life as hard as I possibly could, not just taking the safe route. The safe route is boring. Look at you. When was the last time you took a serious risk? Exactly.
I just don't see the point. I mean, there are so many things that you can do in life to get somewhere that don't involve risk. Like, why drive a motorcycle when you can drive a car, you know? Life can be fulfilling without scaring yourself to death every day.
Fulfilling? Boring as hell, maybe. It's like sleepwalking through life. Why not drive the motorcycle? That rush, that's what makes us alive.
Okay, I get it. No need for the expansive rhetoric. Maybe you should go into theater.
Come on, let's go. Where are we going? You're gonna take a risk.
make an impression on us. She may never regain full brain function.
I want to pull the plug.
There's still a chance that she...
She wouldn't want to live like that, and she certainly wouldn't want to live like she is now.
I'm here. I'm sorry.